All across America, communities are hoping they won't ever have to get public notices like what Louisiana State University sent out on Tuesday afternoon.
Today around 2:30 p.m., LSU police received a report of an armed intruder inside Coates Hall.
The school, which was hosting freshman orientation, was placed on lockdown while police investigated and soon determined that there was no shooting threat. The flood of first responders at LSU has been a common knee-jerk reaction to mass shooting incidents in the country, especially after the attacks in El Paso, Texas, and Dayton, Ohio earlier this month that left at least 31 people dead. The frustration boiling over to the streets, demonstrators calling for legislators to pass bills on background checks on all gun sales and on red flag laws, a measure that would temporarily prevent someone in crisis from accessing firearms if they pose a danger to themselves or others. This past weekend, rallies were held in dozens of towns and cities across the country.
Enough!
Enough!
All throughout this month, while senators are back home for recess, calls for gun reform legislation continue, with activists showing up to senator district offices and more rallies planned in various cities in coming weeks.
We understand that, you know, violence can happen to any safe place. That's why we make sure that we equip our police department with the necessary tools to prevent this this tragedy.
PhilM Councilman Arvin Amatorio, who is running for Bergenfield mayor this November 5th, said gun violence, whether from mass shootings or local crime activities, pose complex challenges on smaller towns.
Really, you know, the banning these weapons absolutely is beyond the pay grade of the council. It's, you know, it's number one. We have rules, you know, the federal government regulates this thing, the state government regulates these things. New Jersey has one of the strictest gun laws, and still there are violence that occur.
Meanwhile, President Donald Trump faced backlash when reports came out that he seemed to be backing away again on universal background checks. He reportedly told a National Rifle Association leader on Tuesday that it is off the table. This after he told reporters earlier that the U.S. already has very strong background checks. On Wednesday, Trump denied the report and instead gave his reassurance that something is getting done on gun legislation.
An appetite for background checks. We're going to be doing background checks. We're working with Democrats. We're working with Republicans. We already have very strong background checks, but we're going to be filling in some of the loopholes, as we call them, at the border.
According to a nonprofit group, Gun Violence Archive, which tracks real-time gun violence incidents in the country, as of Tuesday night, there have been nearly 36,000 gun-related incidents so far this year. Len Amadine Thornhill, ABS-CBN News, Bergenfield, New Jersey.